Oh, you run it faster? Yeah, because we
you
ran
have,
for
you
three
have to be,
beats.
You have to be like, you have to be faster. You have to, less. I know you like to have your little extras bits and the how you kill them thing, but that those add up over time and slow the game down overall.
Yeah, but it makes it more fun, it man. You gotta do that stuff, right?
Yeah.
Tell him, man. Wait, where are you, man? You're not even defending me anymore. You seem a little grouchy tonight.
What's going on?
He's picking on me again, man.
Oh, come on. That's just normal. He's being grumpy and trying to come up with some obscure rule to derail the fun. The enemy of fun over there is looking for the rules.
Derail the fun.
Yeah.
That is not true, man. He's added more to this game than anyone else because he actually knows. He keeps things moving.
Oh, yeah.
Have you seen us try to look things up in the book, dude? It's not good.
Yeah.
Things come to a grinding halt whenever we have to go look up the rules. Okay,
a day without me has been that.
Yeah. No, 2 weeks ago we were looking up our healing spells. We had some new guy. It was like his first time, and he was laughing at us. Okay, so we got.
But I see you guys actually got in track and went and found Harshnag.
We did. We've got Harshnag.
Harshnags. Yep.
Harshnag.
And they're at the eye. They're at the eye of the Allfather right now.
Oh, okay, cool.
Just started it.
Yay.
So you're not playing Vord?
No, I'm playing Verzidon, my
okay,
my scholar.
I'm gonna make you
character.
A new card.
You're what?
My scholar.
James is not here.
Was he a magic user?
Yes, he is. He is one level cleric and eight levels of wizard.
Okay.
Jeff is here.
A knowledge cleric.
Sam is here.
He's basically the character I play, so I don't have to
Mark
worry about meta for monster stats because like, he knows because he has all the knowledge skills and two of them are expertise. Also,
expertise, man.
Expertise.
Yeah, he's not messing around.
Where's your son?
He had homework to do. My son is homeschooled.
Okay.
So he had archery today, and the archery instructor, who has a name. There's a name for a...
Harshnag.
No, for like an archery coach.
Legolas?
No, it's like a... It's not... It's like...
Fletcher?
Yeah,
Fletcher?
It's got a strange name like
that. Those are the ones that make the arrows.
Yeah. He's got... There's a name like that, though, for the master of the archery arena.
Oh, internet, what is the name of that?
Right, so he brought stuffed animals to the archery today,
oh,
so the
awesome.
Kids got to shoot moose and quail and all these kinds of things. So they were at archery for like an extra 4 hours killing dead animals. Anyone have nice writing? Mark, not bad.
Okay.
You nailed it. I mean, that's pretty good writing.
Yeah.
Doctor Flit.
That would be fun doing archery in the stuffed animals.
I remember boys had the shot. I just shot down. I was just doing target shooting.
Yeah, we need to get some organization. If any of you guys have any kind of like skills in organizing people, we'd really like to embrace that because we're struggling. Yeah. What happened last week is my son put it in the dishwasher.
What in the dishwasher?
In the dishwasher, but like in the dishwasher and ran it. And I'm not really sure how that happened.
Dave!
That's where that happened. Yeah.
Why go put in the dishwasher?
So is it a toxic flit or something like that?
What is it?
Toxic flit. To someone who's an expert archery.
What could put in the dishwasher?
Talk to Flat. No?
That doesn't sound right. Scott, what's your character name?
Varus.
V-E-R-A...
V-A-R.
V-A-R-A-I-S.
Yes.
Game of Thrones ripoff. Sorry. What, a scholar?
Varus and
your... It's probably the elven.
And you're a mage?
Yeah, let's just go with mage. Why don't we go with that?
Okay. So you got a faction?
Lord's Alliance.
What wound up in the dishwasher?
The sign-up sheet from last week.
Oh, whoops.
Always serve the kings, Lord's Alliance. Yeah.
You're not going to let this one go, are you,
no,
man?
No, pretty much going to hang on to this one. I see all the ways it lines up.
Vanish.
No. He can make people disappear.
Okay.
Yeah, make that charisma. Make a DC 17 charisma save.
Yes.
So you guys are. Why are we at the Temple of the Allfather? The Eye of the Allfather.
We followed Harshnag through harsh weather here.
Okay, and why did we think this was a good idea?
For science!
We were trying to get more information on the Ordning, the breaking of the Ordning.
Right. You're now convinced it's been ruptured.
Right.
The Giants are all pursuing their own evil ends to try to move up. You know that the Hill Giant Queen is trying to make herself the most giant, fattest creature on the planet, which will please the Allfather and make her in charge of everything.
Okay.
You're not sure that's the best plan, but you're sure that's what she's up to, right? And that's why she's stealing all the food and eating everything. You've interacted quite a bit with cloud giants. You're not sure what they're up to, and stone giants, and they seem to be meditating. You didn't see them engaged in a lot of wackiness.
What? You didn't do that part with stone giants?
Not yet. And then the frost giant, the only one you've actually interacted with, is Harshnag.
Right.
He has been slaughtering hill giants primarily, back and forth to Waterdeep and kind of protecting the Descend Valley in general. So he doesn't really have much additional information, except for he knows that the Storm King has gone missing.
Oh, the Storm King, and he has daughters or something?
Right. Yeah. The Storm King's daughters are looking for him, or have tried to take the throne, or there's some kind of Game of Thrones machinations going on.
So that's why
on.
We're at the Eye of the Allfather, because that's the entrance.
You don't know how to find him.
Oh, okay.
So finding the Storm King is kind of your general mission right now. Like, you think, if you want to, you guys believe that reestablishing the Ordning is probably the best bet? To do that, you probably need the Storm Giants to step back up and be in charge. That's probably the fastest way to get it reestablished, unless you want to go feed the big fat hill giant a lot of food. Those are kind of the two options as we see today. Yeah, yeah. Let's go without Minnie so we can go kind of quickly.
Yeah.
You have approached the Eye of the Allfather. You have gone through a giant entryway that is lit. And as you approach a stairwell that leads up to two giant doors, there is another party ahead of you.
Yeah, weren't we just about to...
Some of you had snuck up on them. Others were kind of waiting back with Harshnag. Harshnag was not sure what you guys were trying to do.
Oh, yeah, and I was hanging with Harshnag. I thought Harshnag was just walking up, because he's like, why are we sneaking?
Yeah, yeah. You guys told him to shh, and so then some guys snuck up, and they were going to roll initiative
when
we stopped.
Mr. Huge Size clank clank with the metal, with the plate mail.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was our stinky rogue, both of our stinky rogues, which aren't here.
Correct.
So they think, just kind of fade into the shadows.
Yes, exactly. They sneak so well that they actually disappear.
So this is the Entretal, right?
Yes. You know where we are?
Yes, what's your character again? Because I'm running this part right now for one of my groups.
So at the foot of the door, you guys can see a group of Uthgard barbarian-looking people, one of whom has got a white dragon wormling on a chain with her.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
Good. And how many of them are there?
There are...
a whole lot.
6, 7, 8 plus the dragon.
There's only four of us now.
Plus Harshnag. So
plus Harshnag.
We get a Harshnag. Yeah. So, I mean, we don't really know if they're bad, good or bad at this point. I mean, we don't have anyone sneaky to sneak up on them. I say we just walk on up and say hi.
Okay.
What do you guys think?
Scholars here.
I mean, Harshnag could put a whooping if he needed to.
With that 21 AC? Yeah, I'm pretty sure. Oh, yeah, you guys don't know about that.
No.
It's really nice plate armor.
Is there any way we could slide this table that way a little bit without creating too much chaos?
I arranged the mats to not be that
way.
No,
it looks perfect, and maybe I can get in here. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, the problem with this is the mat is draped on the other side there, not on this side.
Yeah, no. I don't in any way think that I'm criticizing this setup, man. As far as I can tell, it is perfect. Anyone have any complaints?
I never complain.
Yeah.
I leave all the complaining up to the grumpy.
I'm assuming I'll see invisibility put on myself.
You're casting invisibility on yourself?
No, see invisibility on myself.
Oh, you've got to see invisibility on yourself.
This is an 8-hour spell, effectively, though. So I'm just like,
Okay, so, Let's just be a band of merry adventurers and, I mean, you know, we'll kind of approach them with Harshnag and see what they're doing. I mean, I guess, do they look like they're adventuring, or are they here like guarding? I mean,
no, they're trying to get in through this door. It looks like they're frustrated.
Maybe they're the same, maybe they're doing what we're doing, trying to figure out what's going on.
Aren't they like savages or something?
They're Uthgard barbarians, so similar to Vorg. They're tree Grumpy, worshipping,
not very social,
violent.
That's only Vorg. That's only Chigos.
Generally very hostile and violent, primitive at some level. They don't have a good reputation. They're a step above orcs, but not by a lot, I think is fair to say.
Hence why Vorg stay.
They don't go into towns very often. They're shunned.
Usually they have a bad reputation because they raid. Okay. They don't really make their own life.
These are not from the same tribe as Vorg is from. These are more ice barbarians, if you know, like that kind of thing.
If we just stand here, they're eventually either going to get through the door or they're going to get frustrated and turn around and leave, and they're going to run into us.
Yeah.
So, I mean, we're going to have to probably confront them at some point.
Yep.
So I say we go forward.
All right, so you approach them, and you hear what appears to be clearly their leader turns to you and says, "What have you done with our men? Return them immediately!" And they start to take arms against you.
Okay, we roll this now.
We say, "We haven't taken any men.
They disappeared here! I know that you've captured them! You need to return them to us immediately!"
We're just adventurers, like you are. We've never been here before.
We're not really adventurers.
Did you say that?
We're the Sword Coast Collective.
Three of them start charging down the hall.
Yep,
at you.
Okay. We get initiative rolls.
They definitely think that you've somehow captured or kidnapped some of their guys.
Says, we're just looking for a way in. We'll be glad to help find your guys.
Okay. Wait, hold on.
Are you looking for a pen?
Yeah, I am. Do you see it?
Yeah, right there.
In your book.
In the book. Thank you.
I got a 3. I'm doing well today.
Get those out of the way earlier.
Yeah. That'd be actually interesting to run statistics on your diary.
We have 2 tier 2 characters. This is going to be wonderful.
So your fellow. Is this supposed to be for tier 3?
No, it's not. No, none of the book is involved. Only the very back end of it is adventures even close to tier 3.
Okay.
Everything else beyond the
tier 2-ish.
Yeah, this is all tier 2, and no, it's basically 10 or 10 plus. It's about 10 plus, but it's only that the back end is 10. That is 10, maybe. And I said that, you can probably go to 11 also if you want to.
Everyone's got their initiative?
Yeah.
Yep, I got mine.
Okay, Scott.
16.
16. Jeff.
18.
18.
Dex mod.
Sam.
15.
15. And Mark.
2.
What do you have? What do you have?
Paladin.
Oh, okay. All right.
You surprised with my Dex mod?
No, I was like, I thought you played a Ranger before. Oh, okay.
We had some rangers.
It was a different time. So if I remember, because there's a bunch of shirtless, or at least semi-shirtless. Shirtless barbarians.
Aren't you guys cold? You need some jackets?
Oh, they are in total cold weather.
Cold weather gear, yes.
Yeah.
But they're for the most part shirtless barbarians. No armor. No real armor. There's one, I think there's some kind of like a shaman in the back, or somebody that looks like a...
Will you stop telling us what we should know?
What we should know, which we see in front of us.
No, I don't think
yes,
we see
do
that.
Yes, we do see this in front of us. You told us about the white dragon already.
Yeah, I want that as a pet, don't kill it.
I'm totally going to get that as a horse.
I think it's medium size. It's not even big enough for a mount.
It's my new dog. It's gonna go great with my cat.
Okay, 16.
That's why Varys brings his own Tressum.
Ward's gone.
No, not Ward. I just said Varys brings his own Tressum.
Oh, okay.
Oh, he's got one too?
Actually, I got one from Fai Shen at the con.
You traded for it?
No, I bought it.
What you
from
bought?
Fai Shen.
Okay, order is Jeff, Varys.
Varys,
the Wormling, Sam, the Berserkers, the Shaman, the Captain, and Fred. Go ahead, Jeff. So you've basically got three barbarians charging with axes towards you that are going to be engaged with you this round. You've got six more that are kind of holding back but look like they're about to charge, waiting kind of for a command word from the captain. The white dragon wormling has turned and is facing you. The shaman is beginning invocation.
Well, I can I communicate with them before I have to take an action?
Yeah.
So
yeah, you can always talk.
As we're not enemies and we didn't take your men, we'd be glad to try to help recover them.
Oh, and you've come to loot the treasure which is rightfully ours. You shall never have it.
What treasure?
That's what they say.
Okay, so I'm pulling
this
out.
This is ours.
I pull up my sword. I step forward.
The leader says that, actually.
The other ones
are kind of like treasure.
Yeah, we're not here looking for treasure.
I am.
What would you like to do?
Well, are they still charging me?
They are charging.
Okay, I'm moving forward, and I'm going to meet them.
Okay.
How far away are we?
They're about 20 feet away.
Okay, so there's three of them.
Yeah,
you want to get forward somewhat.
And I'm going boom right there in the middle.
Okay, do you have minis out for me?
Yeah, those are your three.
Oh, those are my three guys.
Yeah.
Okay, let's put some more guys out for me. So, I'm going to be D6s. So here's. Does everyone have minis?
Yes, I do. I actually do have an appropriate mini for this character. Yeah. Quote unquote.
So the lines on the board don't matter. We're basically in a giant hallway.
Put me there.
One. Two. D6s. Three.
It's a penguin.
Four. Five. Six.
Though it's not really meaningful.
You want an actual mini?
Sure.
Here you go.
Seven. Eight.
Yeah.
By this guy?
There you go.
Is that you?
That's me.
Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
That's a Tressen familiar.
Two.
It's a flying cat.
And dragon.
Cat with wings.
You bought one and then you got a document saying you paid for it.
Yep.
Imaginary.
I didn't pay for it. It paid for it in game gold.
Then why did you get an out of game?
Normally through the rules you can't actually have a Tressen as a familiar because find familiar only does a certain subset of things. Not trusting.
Okay.
This is the way you're getting things outside the game is you like going to cons and stuff like that.
Oh, okay.
When you participate in that stuff.
All right, go ahead.
That's it. The 1,000 gold, it says 1,000
okay,
gold.
Okay, I attack the one in the middle.
Gotcha. Berserker number two.
And I miss. And then I do my second attack on him.
Their armor class is not great.
16.
16 is a hit.
Okay. That's going to be 1d8. 8, 9, 10,
13. 13 points of damage to the Berserker. He is still alive.
Okay.
Next up is Varius the Mage.
Do I see any, like, spellcasters?
The Shaman is chanting. She is number one. So this number one is a Shaman
which
to a dragon. She's in this square. Dragon is in this square.
Right, so
these guys are at the door. These guys are loitering. Doors are here. There are stairs here. You guys are. You need some damage dealers. You guys don't. Where's our deadly ranger?
I know.
We're gonna die.
You're gonna die.
No, I'm fine, because I take the air. Wing boots, baby.
Alright.
They can't hit me.
They can't hit you, that might be true.
Yeah, this is gonna be, it'll be a long fight.
Yeah, so let's see.
My goal is to keep them from getting to our frail
Game
of Thrones wizard.
Three, four, six. I'm flying up the air just around here. Is there like a little
portable floating thing?
Yeah, here we go. This is good.
So it's just a, I am 20 feet in the air.
Gotcha.
And then for them, let's see. It is a 10-foot... Yes, it's 10 feet off. Its square range is 90 feet.
Cool. That's exactly what I want.
So...
No, I'm sorry.
So.
Sound effects too. Is that a?
It's a. I basically conjure a big ball of water.
Okay.
Right underneath them. It's basically a katamari.
Okay. Just these two?
Yeah.
Okay.
So both of them give me strength saves.
A 5.
So DC 17.
Yeah, they both fail.
So they are both engulfed in water. For the risky shit, the risky kept inside that.
Okay.
They are restrained and they are like I said, they are in water.
And restrained and drowning are their only qualities? Save ends? How do they get out of this thing?
They have to use an action to make a strength save.
Okay.
Strength save to eject themselves out. What?
What are they in?
They're in a big ball, a 10-foot sphere of water.
They're in a ball of water. The fact that it's really cold, does that matter?
I don't know. Does it?
Not yet. However, if the wormling uses its breath weapon to freeze the water, we might have to have a different discussion.
Awesome. Yes. The wormling is young and stupid.
Yes, exactly. Is that it? You just moved in to cast this deadly ball of water. The wormling is going to try to get out of this water ball.
Right, DC 17.
DC 17 strength save. Does she have anything else to help her?
That's Harshnag.
Oh, and yeah, you can run Harshnag. He can participate. Do you have his stats?
He's a frost. I know
Frostjaw. Yeah, yeah.
He has them memorized.
We could get a mini if you want to get a mini.
Grade.
Do we have a huge base? I couldn't find a huge base at the con. That's the one big disappointment I have.
So 19 saves. So the wormling can take just standard movement out of
they
the
are,
water?
He's ejected out of the sphere. That's his action.
Does he move how many squares as he wants, or?
Creatures are trying to say.
Didn't she have him on a leash?
Yeah, she just dropped the leash.
Oh, she dropped it. Okay.
She dropped the
she
leash and
pulled
he,
out.
He pulls himself out. Yeah, there she's struggling to breathe. She's drowning currently.
Awesome.
No, that's bad news. You're rooting for these guys.
Why?
Their friend is lost. They need help.
But they charged us.
Yeah, you're invading their space. They're very territorial.
Why bother? Gonna have a hard time breathing water. I don't know.
Oh, no, it's at the end of their turn they make the same.
Okay.
Makes it into, and that's the end of his turn.
So
he's
just
done.
Out of the
he's
the match.
And that's
okay.
All he's done.
Sam, you're up.
Oh, okay.
You got the map? Giant hallway, stairs,
yeah.
Barbarians.
And this dude here?
Yep.
All right. I'll engage whoever was
It's
damaged.
Not exactly Harshnag, but it's something.
Okay, he attacked number two.
Yeah. What? Oh.
Okay.
Harshnag?
Bag of M&M's.
Well, that's Harshnag.
Well, that's actually Baron Regime from Ark of the Mountains, but yeah, close enough.
Okay, 21 to hit.
21 to hit.
But it's a huge base. That's the real thing.
Okay. Oh, I can reroll. I don't mind taking the lead, so I'm going to be quiet. I'm going to send my... So 9.
9 points of damage. Got it.
For what, characters?
Yeah.
You moved, you attacked.
Yeah.
The Berserkers.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Those three attack, all of them attack you.
Because they pull out javelins and throw at them?
No, they are axing. They're great axing. No, these guys haven't done anything yet. They did their first move to there. Three great axe attacks on you.
They're not gonna go.
My high is a 19.
Miss.
So they all miss. Can I move? So then these guys will second move again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Up to the giant. Put another one here. And these two back here. That guy is not gone yet. The berserkers are done. The shaman.
Shaman
ends her turn, tries to break out with a plus two. She got a natural 20, so she pops out.
Yep.
Can she choose where she pops out?
Yeah, sure, why not?
I would like to pop out next
to
my dragon.
The nearest space within there, I'd say. Yeah, but that's
fine. Is that fine? Okay. Berserker Captain turns. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Charges to there, but does not get to you guys. He is furious. Mark, you're up.
Sacred Flame.
Mm-hmm.
And on the captain guy.
Okay. He rolls a 9. It's a dex save, right? So it's a 10, which is a failure.
When it's a D8.
Mm-hmm.
I got a 1. Yay.
Okay, he takes his damage. He's, the light of Lathander is not glowing so strongly within this temple. It's like there's other divine forces that work against you.
You didn't do the voice.
Yeah.
If you had done the voice,
the voice
would have
definitely helped. That definitely would have helped. Lathander end of round 1, not a very eventful round. Round 2, Jeff, you're up. You've got a bunch of barbarians here,
okay,
man.
I'm attacking number 2 again. Okay, that is a hit.
Okay.
Okay. That's going to be a 5 plus 5, so that's 10 damage.
Mm-hmm.
Attack second time. That is a crit.
Ooh, that's not going to go well for me.
Okay. I'm assuming that guy was still up, right?
Yeah, after 10, he's got... Yeah, he's okay. Still up.
That's 10, 17, 22 points of damage.
For the crit does 22 separate damage, so that's... Dies.
Gone. So he's gone. Okay. So I'm then going to use my my action surge. Okay. And do 2 more attacks. I'm going to attack number 3.
Okay.
So what do I want to do? Yeah, let's go number 3. That is going to be a 12.
12 is a miss.
No, I'm sorry, 14.
Hits. 14 hits. On number 3.
That's 13 points of damage.
Got it.
Another attack. That is also going to be a hit. That would be a 17.
17.
And that's 10 points of damage.
All right, so I got 23 total on number 3.
Okay.
You don't want to move. You're happy where you are.
I'm happy where I'm at.
All right, Varus. They seem to have escaped from your water sphere. Can you move it on them again?
I move the sphere towards them. They both need to make the saves.
All right.
So move that sphere towards
them. She's red. She gets a 16. He gets a 17. So you got it.
So I got
her.
The shaman. Oh, the shaman. Yeah. No, they both moves into the space. It moves into the space, and he ejects it out out the side there. Yeah, like that.
He ejects out.
Yeah.
Okay. And she's trapped. Okay.
She's drowning.
She's drowning again, but she got a fresh breath of air every 6 seconds. Each round is 6 seconds long, so she's doing okay right now.
Got a big breath of fresh air. It's not about her. It's not about drowning her. It's about keeping it under control.
Casting spells. He's trying to kid her.
A couple fireballs. It's gonna hurt.
She doesn't look like... Her magic is a satchel of sticks and twigs.
Now they're all wet.
They're wet glorious. Sticks and twigs. She looks angry. Furious.
So let's see.
Furious even.
She is a berserker as well. So she's a furious, wet twig berserker at this point. You don't see this very often.
I'll fly.
In fact, I've never seen this before. The giant didn't go last round. Two, do you want him, three, do you want to do the giant
five,
on your turn?
Six, I'll fly over to there.
Okay.
Six. Does Hirsch need get multiple shots?
He does.
All right, cool. I'll go and smack the nearest one to me.
Number 5.
I hit him with both times.
Okay.
He takes 50 damage.
50 points of damage and dies.
Gone. Okay.
Number 5 is dead.
Because I know what the AC of these things are.
That's the barbarian. That's the end of Varus. Nothing else. You move. Oh no, you didn't. You.
Nope. I had to.
You're concentrating.
It's an action to move. It's action to move the sphere.
Okay, got it. So the wormling is now up. And
I'm
mobile.
20 feet up in the air.
Can this thing fly? It has a fly speed. It can come attack you.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4. It is going to fly at you.
Okay.
Do we have another die container? Dice container?
Right there.
Yep.
No.
So the dragon flies up at you, and we're going to do just a straight bite attack.
Okay.
I got a 15 versus armor class.
Miss. 17 AC.
Not even doesn't do that much damage. And it screams out in draconic, "I will be free of these barbarians!"
Yeah, you can just fly out that. I just came back in Draconic. You just go that. You go out that way.
You just say that in Draconic?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Wormling misses. Sam, you're up.
He's like, okay. Sure. Yeah, try it out that way. We're not going to stop you.
Attacking 3.
Okay.
14. Hit.
14 is a
I'll
hit.
I'll take the collar, whatever he has a leash on.
I don't really care about leash. No. I'd rather just see him gone.
For 11.
11 points of damage on number 4. Is that what you said? You
hit him? Sorry. 15.
You want to hit the same one that he hit or the other one?
3.
Okay, yeah, so you hit the same one for 15, so he's at that. Okay, still alive.
That's all.
Yeah. That's it? Okay, you don't move, you're good. The Berserkers go. Okay, I've got plenty of attacking opportunities here. So we're going to do a little movement. The leader's going to move up and post on you. These two are here. This one, these three...
Aren't they even a little bit intimidated by the giant?
No, they're furious.
I'm pretty sure they're...
It's just right here. They seek conflict wherever they can find it. It's right there in the monster manual.
I don't feel as bad now, because I thought I was going to talk us out of this.
But, yeah. Okay, so these all have to attack you, right? Because you've got them marked.
Yeah.
Okay, so these three each attack you with an axe. My high roll is a... What is it?
I thought they only know Bothy.
Yeah, they only speak stupid.
So basically, it's all gibberish to us.
Yeah, the leader can speak Common.
Okay,
he yelled in Common.
Ward is the only one that actually can speak Bothy in the entire group.
23.
Yeah, they both.
So that's 10 points of 18 points of axe damage.
Okay.
Wow.
One attack on you, for a 24.
Yeah.
9 points of damage. And then four on the...
Okay, hold on.
Me?
Who attacked?
This one.
Oh, for Hart. Oh, for her.
Okay,
he's out of your range, right? Those three are in range, and then these three are going to attack the...
Karshnag.
My high roll is a 23 and a 16.
High roll is 23 hits.
9 points of damage. All
right.
If you could track that for me, I would appreciate it.
You appreciate
it. Berserkers are done. These guys, actually, that were up here first that have been missing you a lot, they don't look... like, their berserker rage is not as great as this guy. This guy is excited to be here.
That guy.
He's ready to attack. This one fired up to fight a giant, right? The ones that have been missing, their enthusiasm is diminishing.
Okay.
The shaman ends her turn trying to get out of this stupid thing. 19.
Yeah, she makes. She gets out.
She pops out.
Because she can't cast spells while she's inside. She can't form verbal components while she's drowning.
Captain already attacked. I already rolled his attack. And then, Fred, you're up.
Well, let me heal this guy. I'll use healing word. 1d4 plus 6. There, you got 10 points. Awesome. By the Founder, I heal you.
Awesome.
You know, I found out my god is actually the same as the Founder. A Montour is just.
A Montour is Lathander's an aspect of Onomonitor.
Okay. Lathander's the one that keeps disappearing and coming back and disappearing on Onomonitor.
Onomonitor is the one that actually keeps disappearing and coming back.
Okay.
He's the one that actually recently did come back.
Gotcha.
But he's keeping all things in check. All things going correctly. All the spheres of celestial, all the celestial spheres going in the correct alignment. Basically, he keeps track of the time stream.
Right. But
like that.
Lathander's more like playful Apollo.
They are not the same kind of thing.
Yeah.
Lathander is much more. Amontor is very much the stern. It's almost tear-like in his sternness.
There you go, man. Jeff, you're up.
Okay, I'm going to use my inspiration.
Gotcha.
That gives me advantage, right?
Yep.
You want the skag for that? Did you read this guy for a monitor?
That's 15.
Yeah.
So that's going to be a hit,
mm-hmm.
I think.
Now, are you posting up against the captain, or
no,
are you sticking
captain.
With number 3?
No, I'm going to the captain.
Captain, okay.
That's 10 points of damage.
Wow.
I'm going to attack again.
There we go.
And that's on top of the one that he did to him last round.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
yeah, I tried.
You loosened him up,
it's only
man.
At 12. I think
12
it's
is
a miss.
It's
a miss.
You got to get to the 13.
Yep.
So you did 10.
Yep.
You're not moving. You're happy where you are.
I'm happy.
You're up. There's a dragon right in front of you. When you said just keep flying, he kind of looked down the hallway and looks like that may be his move.
I tell you, you should offer to take his leash off him.
He has a leash already off. He'll just chew it off.
He has a leash on him still, but it's not impinging his flight.
Then we might as well not attack him.
Just take the leash and command him.
Put the woman back in the ball.
Oh yeah, I have to. Yeah, I should probably do
that.
What kind of party is this, man?
It's definitely not National Women's Day like it was last week.
Sure, I'll attempt to shove her back in. Shove her back in. Yeah.
Oh, 18.
Yeah, she's back. So she gets ejected back out.
Okay. Do you want to move?
I want the wormling.
I shall step aside then. Let's see. So I'll just go in here like that.
Okay.
He fights you from the side.
No, he doesn't take an attack.
No, I'm not moving out of the attack opportunity range.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. The wormling does appear to be flying for the exit.
All right, then.
Sam.
Okay, so who's this guy? Is this the captain?
The captain is the D4 right here. So okay. You could attack him. You've got these three. But he's definitely, like, posting up against the pirate. Like, that's important to him that he kills the pirate.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Harshneck is what initiative?
Yours. Did we miss Harshneck? Okay, let's just finish up with Sam and then... Or you can take your next.
Harshneck does 50 damage to another one. Actually, it does 52 damage because he has a plus... The Gertrude Great Act is plus one. Oh, he does more damage, actually. He does an extra D6 on top of that. It does, like, a lot. It just
okay.
wrecks.
Kind of nature is Wrath 8?
Yes.
Which restrains... Is that 10 feet?
Let's see.
From you, yeah. Yep. I know that's 15. 5, 10, 15.
It's an action, so I can't move and do it, can I?
No, you can move, and then you can do that. Okay, but if you move, you're going to take opportunity attacks.
Oh.
Unless you can somehow stay within... I mean, it would be tricky
just
to
kill the guy
there.
Next to you.
Okay. I'll attack 3 again.
Okay. 3 does look pretty badly damaged.
14?
Oh, it does extra 2d12 on a hit. I guess.
That hits?
So that's another, like, 13 damage. So it does, like, 65.
So for 15 damage?
15 damage on number 3, he dies. Boom. It is now the Berserker's turn.
Berserker.
This one attacks you, misses. This one attacks you, misses. These two attack Harshnag, both miss. Lame. Uthgard's Shaman is free of this. She moves one. Does she have any idea how fast this thing moves? How far have you been?
It can move about 30 feet around.
Three, four.
She can't.
Five,
she has
six.
Her dash to get out of the way.
Yeah, yeah. So she moves to here and fires two arrows at you.
She's just shooting at me.
Yeah, both miss. Twing, twing. She also has a spear and a spell component bag. She did not cast a spell. The Berserker Captain attacks you. 18 is a miss, and that is them. It is Fred's turn. You're just warming up? What are you doing here, man? You're making me nervous.
Warming up. It was my turn.
Flame on... is she too far away for that?
From you? She's a long way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Yes, one. You have to go. Through.
You can move forward one.
I'd have to move forward one?
Correct.
I'm back here.
Yeah.
Can I move and do that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I move. Like here.
Yep.
And I do Sacred Flame on her.
And she fails the saving throw?
By the fender!
See?
Six.
See?
Definitely better. That's her first damage, actually. But yes, you hit her and she catches on fire. She radiantly ignites. End of round 2, guys. That was way better round. Round 3, Jeff, you're up. Thaddeus, you've got the barbarian
captain
in front of you.
That's going to be a miss. 16.
16 is a hit?
It's 13 damage.
Got it. You're happy where you are? You don't want to move in?
Nope. I'm good right there.
Okay. Varius, you're up. The dragon is continuing to fly away. It does look back at you in a spiral of, like, farewell or something comes out of its nostril. You know this is a traditional dragon thank you.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. La, 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 la.
This is comical, actually.
I'm just basically keeping her completely tied up almost.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Is she drowned at this point?
No, she keeps getting out,
getting a breath, and going back in. Plus, each round is only 6 seconds long, so she would have to be in there for like two rounds.
But she's not on fire anymore.
Well, she wasn't ever on fire. That's it.
That's all I got.
The Harshnag, does he want to do attacks?
Harshnag! Harshnag do like tons of damage. Harshnag hits once, but he hits for 39 points of damage.
Still alive.
Yes.
Okay.
Because hitting humans is really good for your...
And he begins to sing a song of battle. His helmet has kind of come down over his mouth and he's...
Harshnag! Yeah, he... I am whacking guards.
The wormling flies out and is gone.
Yeah, to move you, hosiers.
Oh, that's right.
Canadian Harshnag.
Someone believes that he's Canadian.
Canadian.
So he sings like, hey, get out, eh?
I'm whacking guards. Hey,
Sam, you're up.
Everybody loves Canadian Harshnag.
Six has not been hit.
One.
A fumble. Nice work. You miss.
Who does he hit?
And the Berserkers, he won't let me use fumble tables.
Because that's not part of the... it's kind of BS. That's not part of the...
But fumble tables are great.
No.
Come on, they're awesome.
No, they're
awesome.
No. This one attacks you with a 23.
Yeah.
Take 9 points of damage. This one attacks you, misses. The leader will attack you as well, just so I don't forget to roll. And those two will attack Harshnag. Both miss. Berserkers are done.
They're berserkers, aren't they?
Yeah, I know. They're supposed to be hitting.
No, the berserker thing with
that. No, the shaman saves.
Does it? Does he save?
No.
Okay, she doesn't save.
She's still trapped. The captain attacked. And Mark, you're up.
Save your flame again.
You need a heal?
I'm at two.
He's at 2 hit points.
You actually do rolls for intimidation.
Your ally looks very bloody.
Sorry about that. healing word.
Oh, come on, Sacred Flame, you got her!
Healing word.
They're kind of
by Lysander! Sorry about that.
Are they more afraid of them or of their boss? And more like
it was a little bit late, so I think he's got to maybe roll it while it dies up here and then bring it down.
By the land of Lysander, I bring you life!
It's
something like that.
So you've healed. End of round 3, round 4. Jeff, you're up.
I'm attacking the captain.
Kill the goblins first anyway.
Yeah, and then with all
that's going to be a hit.
Hits?
Remember,
that's 13 points of damage.
13 takes it.
Okay.
It only lasts for D4.
That's a fumble miss.
Yeah. Nice. We're getting a fumble table. The first chance we get, man.
Next time he's not here, we'll just throw it in there for fun.
We just get it out for color. We'll just get it out for color.
Well, he's supposed to say he's attacking.
I have a question.
I'm ready.
Okay, my cleric has 4 first level spell slots.
Yes.
So he can cast Healing Word 4 times.
Correct.
Okay.
Yeah.
And he has 2 second levels, and he can cast Healing Word. Word.
So can
at
I,
level
can
2
like twice.
And okay.
Not count as an actual.
Yeah, you're a heal bot.
That's a DM call.
Okay, good.
Really. It's kind of like I
you good?
Do it.
Yeah. What yeah. So it says I took my weapon took 1.1d6 damage.
So you bash your blade off of his axe handle and your blade vibrates.
3 points of damage.
Scott, you're up.
Oh, okay. Turn I don't have to do involvement. Actually, no, wait.
Okay. Looks good though.
It smells good. Is it grapefruit or an orange?
It's like one of those,
blood orange.
Yeah.
Nice. Have you ever had a Palumbo?
Just right there.
South American citrus fruit?
Actually, I guess it could.
The peel is like an inch thick.
Really?
So you get it, they're like grapefruit size, but they're like tangerines inside. You're moving?
I'm gonna shove the sphere 1, 2.
She floats around inside the sphere.
Yep.
Do you get them?
No, I can't move fast.
Oh, fantastic! They look and they are terrified. It looks like they may flee. They do not like the looks of this at all. Magic scares
them. But Harshnag can now reach the shaman.
Yeah. Oh, you're a jerk.
Now Harshnag's turn.
Yes.
Harshnag beats the crap out of the shaman.
So he reaches over and smashes the shaman in the bubble.
Harshnag she's also restrained in the bubble.
Mm-hmm.
That's advantage.
Yep. So.
Yeah, there's going to be some damage here.
Yeah, it's going to be a lot of damage.
She can take it. She's tough.
What's her AC?
Her AC is 13.
Yeah, she hits
and
one.
And she's currently
she
sitting
39,
at...
39 points of damage.
She's currently sitting at 32 hit points.
She gets counted
so the ball of water just turns into like a Shirley Temple of
froth. It's like a Bloody Mary.
Yeah, Bloody Mary. It's just filthy gross.
Right, so she's dead. Jump the digger off there. Mm-hmm. He's going to go for another one, and this one not with advantage. Nine, more than 20, I think. So 39 damage to one of the
and
other.
And you've
twice.
Hit number 7.
Yeah,
number
sure,
seven.
Say,
so you hit
seven
again, 7 dies. Sam, you're up. You got your healing. You've got this barbarian. He looks unhappy. He looks over at this ball of blood, and he just looks miserable.
Hey, what's the paladin thing? You had to use a spell slot to do extra damage?
Oh, yeah. It's a divine smite.
Yeah, is that a... what's the dice?
It's 2d8 for the first spell slot, and 1d8 after every spell slot above that.
So you roll to see if you hit first.
So you only
hit
first spells anyway, though, so it doesn't really matter. You only can... So, it's, yeah, roll to hit first.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hit.
I would suggest that since you have so few of them, wait for your crit. Wait for when you crit. Because because it doubles those dice, too.
And you get sick.
And you get, yeah, poly... Smite crits. Crit smites are not. Are
nine?
Nine,
nine
no
plus four. Got 13.
Is that first blood?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, first blood. You could come down with the maul and just right in the head. He does not look like he's enjoying this whatsoever at this point. He is actually going to disengage, so you can take an opportunity attack.
He's disengaging.
Oh, he's disengaging. He's going to take a disengage action, and then he's going to move 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. He's running for the exit.
Kill the rabbit.
So he takes the disengage action to here.
Remember that harsh nag spaces are difficult terrain for him.
So disengage, and then
so,
that would be
so like
4.
One,
there.
2, 3, 4, yeah. Then 5, 6.
This one is staying there, and this one is staying there. Attacking Harshnag with a miss. Attacking you with a
miss.
16 is a miss. End of the Berserker's turn. The Shaman is dead. The Captain attack. Fred, you're up.
What are those? Are they both
running?
Those two are running. These two in front are fully healed. Or which one's damaged more?
Number 8 is not taking damage. Number 6 is running.
The captain is damaged.
The captain has taken damage, but not a lot. Some. 30-ish.
How many hit points does he have?
About 9.
9?
Oh, okay.
Oh, heal him again. Okay. Well, offender!
That's better.
Okay.
There!
It works when you do it.
It works when you work.
It doesn't. 10
points.
It doesn't look.
Offender lives.
Jeff, you're back up.
Okay. I switched dice.
What's this about dying? What was this whole thing about dying? Someone was talking about we're going to die here.
That's a 16. That's a hit.
Yes.
That was me.
That's 12 points of damage. Hit him again. That's a miss.
Okay. You're not moving anywhere. You're up, mage.
Okay.
Vars.
I'm gonna move the sphere over to the lead.
Fails.
Yeah, he is engulfed in water.
Sam, you're up. He's in a pool of water, restrained,
what?
So you have advantage.
Harshnag
is number 8.
Harshnag is gonna go get the other one. Harshnag misses on one, but hits with the other one.
First
take
blood.
39.
Still alive.
So with advantage, you throw another hit die or another damage.
Yeah, roll 2d20s and take the high roll.
Oh yeah, that's right. I already hit.
With a.
Technically, if it's a pool of water, if it's a pool.
Did you roll
blood,
a 20?
I'll do it again.
No. No, it was a natural 20. No. Yeah, always crit fish, right? So you roll them both anyway.
Are you sure? I thought you said it was full of blood now.
Oh, yeah, it is.
It's opaque with blood.
It's opaque with blood.
It's 18.
18's definitely a hit. Is that damage or is that...
That's
a hit. That's a hit. Yeah, absolutely.
Got 10.
10 points of damage. Got it. Berserker on Harshnag. Misses. These guys run. Are you going to try to stop them?
No.
All right, they're leaving. Captain on you. 18
captain,
misses.
The captain is restrained.
Oh, he saves at the end of his turn.
Yeah.
So he saves at the end of the turn with a 19 plus 3, 22.
Yeah,
he pops out here.
We just restrained. He can do stuff. What's his?
He could have made an attack. Fred, you're up.
Let's see. So he lands prone.
Oh, he's prone.
He
okay.
Falls out prone.
He's
oh,
furious.
Oh, that's advantage then.
Yeah, yeah. You'll have
mm-hmm.
advantage unless you do it first.
Sticker flame on number 8.
Okay.
By the fender.
I saved.
Shit. Yeah. So you take half damage?
What?
Or no damage?
Sacred flame.
Yeah.
Okay.
No damage.
No.
No, I saved. Your god has no power here. As I stand in a pool of Uthgard barbarian bloody water. And Jeff, you're up.
Okay, I'm attacking. That's a crit. That's 10, that's 18, that's 23 points of damage to the captain. And then...
still alive.
Okay, I get another one.
Yep.
That's another crit.
Is that on the captain?
Yep.
Yeah. Do we want to kill him or do we want to just save him?
I think I just killed him. 11. that's 16 points of damage.
16 is dead.
Yeah.
Yay.
We asked that question a little too late this time.
Jeff's usually the one asking me, should we kill a question? You didn't like this
one. I already crit it. You can't take back a crit.
Scott, you're up.
Yes. Engulf.
I save.
Oh, he makes a save.
Yeah, this guy's unbelievable. He's the new chief.
Yep. He gets Harshnag then.
Harshnag? Watch this. Dodge it.
What's his AC actually?
His RC is 15. 13.
God damn it. I gotta pull up the friggin' monster manual.
This guy's unbelievable.
Is he
Sam, you're next.
Is he unique or just happens to be lucky?
He's just gonna get very lucky.
He's dead. I just rolled second attack.
Alright.
He took damage
so
in the first one.
You slaughtered a group of Uthgard barbarians and berserkers.
I throw the spear over to the back there and let it just basically sploosh on everything.
So the shaman in her bloody carcass, you do find 250 gold pieces worth of gemstones.
Okay.
As well as her strange shaman satchel, which is full of sticks and twigs.
So what kind of spells
did she
check
skulls.
Out? What did we miss by...
She successfully cast zero spells.
What could she have cast? What kind of...
Mostly healing. Her she was mostly going to buff the guys, keep them fighting.
Really? No. She wasn't going to do that.
It would have been nice if she could. She does have a couple, like, minor attack spells. She's not a high-level caster.
But you know what it is? Counterspell.
Yeah, she got nothing.
Because no character in this game has had that yet.
Oh, you're going to counterspell anybody that tries to cast anything.
Yep.
Okay, so now you are standing
identify the spell first, I guess.
In front of the giant doors. There's 40-foot long flight of steps leading to a 20-foot landing, next to which stands 30-foot granite doors.
Hey, Mr. Harshnag, do you not open these doors?
The doors show giants engaged in battles with dragons.
I don't think any of us are big enough for this door. But Harshnag is, I think.
Harshnag can push on the doors if you want him to.
Yeah, we asked him to push on the doors, even open the doors.
Okay, so any huge or larger creature with a strength of 23 or higher can throw his weight against the doors and force them open.
Oh, yeah, that's definitely Harshnag.
So Harshnag lands his shoulder deeply into the door. He's starting to like you guys, you know, slaughtering barbarians. You guys know how to have a good time. He cracks this door open.
Hey.
Shouldn't we, like, rest and heal up and shit before we go get attacked by something?
We're fine.
Okay, this opens into another giant temple. When the characters enter, they peer in here. Thick frost clings to every surface in this 100-foot-high vaulted chamber. So you guys are fairly deep into the cave structure here, and this is actually all carved. 7 enormous statues dominate the room. The largest of them is an 80-foot-tall robed giant, his arms outstretched and his face hidden beneath a stony cowl. Facing a glowing archway in the east wall, so you're coming in through the west, so on the wall directly across from you, kneeling in rows on each side of a statue, so there's the on that wall there's a glowing archway.
Okay.
Glowing archway on that wall. Huge. Kneeling in rows to each side of this statue are 6 statues half its size, so 40-foot tall statues. Each impressive in its own right and depicting a paragon of each type of giant. Hill, stone, frost, fire, cloud, and storm. These smaller statues face the bigger one in the room's center. In their outstretched arms, 5 of the giants hold weapons, gifts for the Allfather. Only the frost giant statue is unarmed. So they're each kind of like offering weapons to the central statue who's raising his arms at this archway that's in front of him.
So did the frost giant have weapons when someone took them?
It appears that he had a weapon that someone took.
Yay.
There are doors to the north, and there are doors to the south. Giant double doors, 2 sets. each about 20 feet apart.
So, Harshnick, have you actually been here before?
I have not! But clearly this is the All-Father praying to open this portal. We must get through.
So how is the Frost Giant? How are the hands? Is it like holding it like this? Could we tell that it's holding
it? Yeah,
like
kind of like it was offering of... Frost Giant like an axe or something must have been in its hands that it's offering. The Hill Giant has a giant club and it's a male Hill Giant. It's offering it up like this. The Stone Giant has a giant rock that it's kind of offering to the All-Father. These things don't look like part of the statue, though. They actually look like a rock or a club that's been put on the statue or inserted into the statue. The Fire Giant has a sword, a giant great sword. It's huge. The Cloud Giant has a spear, and the Storm Giant, interestingly enough, has a trident, which you're not sure what you were expecting. Maybe lightning bolt, but trident seems a little odd.
Okay, we take the trident out of one guy's hand.
You're going to try to slide the trident out of his hand? You think this trident weighs probably close to 1,000 pounds.
Okay, this is a huge-sized trident.
Yeah, all of these weapons look very heavy.
They're probably made of...
Do we see any other weapons in the room anywhere, the missing weapon?
No, it's not obviously in the room. The doors are closed, the archway is there.
Okay, so let's go to the set of north doors.
As you approach the archway is 40 feet wide and 40 feet tall. 6 different runes are carved into it. Each one inlaid with mithril, and glowing mists fill the arch. Nikes in the walls
niches.
On either
niches.
Side.
Niches.
No, Nikes. N-I-C-H-E-S.
Niche.
Like choke, right? Like
oh, no,
Nikes.
We can go with Nikes.
Nikes in the walls on either side.
They get next to the obelisk.
It's pronounced niche.
They contain empty ice-covered sconces made of iron. So there are runes, giant runes, above a Nike. And then there's like an iron bracket where you could slide something in, perhaps.
We take the Jordans and.
Don't touch anything. Let me.
What do the runes say? You speak everything.
Yeah, I speak giant. At least one of them is giant.
Yeah, no. These are giant runes, and they're definitely the runes that represent the 6 types of giants. So Hog, Siv, Ild, Uvar, Stein, and Esse. You haven't seen Esse very often. That's the Cloud Giant rune, but you've seen Hog a lot, and Serve you've seen several times. The other ones you easily recognize. So each iron sconce is surrounded or enclosed within one of these runes.
What's a sconce?
Where you stick a torch.
That's what I thought.
Scone, should we call it a scone instead? Because my pronunciation is so terrible.
I will start throwing dice.
We really do need to confirm what sconce is a sconce, because...
Yeah. A niche is a niche.
Okay.
Niches
well,
get stitches, man. That's
niches
just...
get stitches. Yes.
So the archway is glowing with mist. I mean, it does look very unusual. It's more than just a painting on the wall.
Do we got to go through the archway to get to the doors?
Harshnag thinks, yeah, absolutely. That's got to be where the oracle is. Through there.
Well, we go where Arfton.
Well, it's not open.
Well, let's open the doors. Can we open the doors?
With the north doors and the south doors?
Yes,
or
yeah,
the
let's
archway?
Go to the north door. Okay. Hold on. There's...
So on the east wall is this giant 40-foot archway
right.
with these sconces
okay.
enclosed in it, right? To the north, there are two sets of double doors about 20 feet apart, and to the south, there are a corresponding 2 sets of double doors. But all the doors are closed.
I doubt it. If we haven't seen any humans come in, considering that the door has been barred for so long, then it might have been, if it was moved by giants, it might not have been moved very far from here. It may have just been misplaced after leaving.
How much of this did you know, and how much of this gets read the dungeon?
Part of it is that, well, like I said, the doors were frozen shut, so there were no actual proper looters coming in. It's not that I can imagine. And then, of course, that would mean that this is probably a holy site. Definitely is a holy site. It's definitely a holy site. So that's going to be to say that they probably will not take the actual object of reverence out. But if it is used as a key and they are removable, then that means they might have been just simply misplaced rather than shattered.
Okay. So,
or simply removed.
What about the sconces? I mean. You specifically called the sconces out. Is it, maybe should we check to see if there's like they move and they open a door or something?
So you approach them and investigate them more closely.
If I wasn't a giant, I would say yes. But as I'm, if I was a giant, I would say yes. We would look at them, but I would assume that touching them may not be the best in a holy place to
Do they look like they receive unique touching objects, or do they all just receive the same thing?
Yeah. So as you approach, you're not touching; you're just looking at them, right? So each one has a very kind of unique shaped entrance, maybe something that would match something else that would fit in there, but they're all different sizes. The one that represents Hill, for example, is much wider than the one that represents Storm.
Okay, so the weapons fit in here.
What do you?
It looks like they would be able to support. I mean, these are giant iron brackets, basically, that look like they would be able to hold almost 1,000 pounds.
Okay.
Like they're not just little, wooden things stuck in the wall.
Still find all the pieces.
Do you know any kind of decorum for this?
Decorum?
Not beyond what I can probably surmise. Is there any kind of decorum that you might know about this?
When you say decorum, you mean?
As in, is there a proper way of actually accessing? I'm going to yell. Like, could you pull out the club for Grand Theft Club and put it in the hog room?
Looks possible.
But do you know?
It looks very heavy.
You're
asking Harshnag if he can do it. Oh, Harshnag can do it, absolutely.
But I'm asking, is there a decorum to this, though?
A decorum? Oh, hill giants are gross.
But I mean, is it hill giant only for this kind of way, or is it?
Well, the Allfather, he's a stickler for the hierarchy.
All right, then that would mean that we need to find.
He likes us all to stay in our places. He doesn't like us moving around. And he really doesn't like you little folk. You probably shouldn't be in here even. This is a pretty sacred looking space.
It's necessary though, I guess.
Yeah. No, we need to talk to the Oracle.
So assume
for sure.
So then Thrym needs his axe then, if that's what this is.
And then let's open some doors.
Well, then there's no doors open, just archways.
No, there are doors. There are doors to the north and doors to the south.
We just gotta open them.
All right, one way looks good as good as another.
Let's go to the north.
Go to the north doors.
North doors.
There's kind of easterly or westerly doors. Do you care?
One as good as the other.
They look exactly the same.
Westerly. I'll let Thaddeus decide.
Westerly.
Okay. You kick in the doors. Yes. They do open easily. There is frost and things are closed here, but as you guys...
huge size doors.
Yeah, you guys are able to open them. They're on well-made hinges. As you look into the area beyond...
You take 2 points of damage.
It looks like, interestingly enough, like a hotel lobby. So as you come in, there are stairs kind of leading down to a statue and then a hallway with doors going off of it. But it's very clean and marbly. It's very sterile looking. The statue that you see is a stone giant statue.
Sorry.
There's
beer in my fridge.
important question. So stairs down leading to a stone giant statue and then a long hallway with doors coming off.
Okay, so I will start walking down the stairs to the stone giant statue. I'm making sure to be very respectful of the giant space and not going to disturb things and not going to take anything.
Okay.
I don't have to worry about it. We don't have our sneaky rogues with us today, so...
That guy wasn't even a rogue who was taking the gems out of shit, was he?
Ranger? He might have been a sneaky
I don't know what he was doing, but he kept on, setting off traps.
Yeah.
I look at the stone giant.
Okay, standing in an alcove, there's an eastern end of the hall, is a giant statue of a stone giant.
Well, let's go look at the other rooms.
Is it? Did anything stick out to me about this giant?
No.
Okay. Does the hall keep going?
So you enter through the doors. There's stairs leading down. You see the door on the other side. Stairs leading down there.
Okay.
Giant statue. Long hallway.
Keep going down the long hallway.
Okay. No dwarves in the party?
A dwarf.
You're a dwarf.
I'm a dwarf.
Give me a check. 17. Wisdom check.
Whatever it was, you rolled a 3.
He's a very wise.
You can have advantage on this roll. Because you are a dwarf.
10.
10 plus.
Wisdom?
10 plus, let's see, do you have training? No, he has just a plus 3, so 13.
13? That's good enough. So as you guys go down the stairs, you look at this giant golem statue, or this giant stone giant statue, and you see this hallway going up, and you notice that the hallway's at a slight angle as you walk down the hallway. It surprises you. You'd expect a flat floor here, but it is definite grade going up.
Someone check.
Okay, I tell everyone to stop. Stop. This is probably a trap somewhere around here. For some reason, the floor is slanted up from where we're standing. But all I know...
I'm not getting a chance to roll anything, so...
Okay, so let's...
I'm not allowed to use my...
So you're at about the first set of doors, and it appears that there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7... 7 doors going down the hallway, just right across from each other. 14 doors total, 7.
What is the length of the hall? What is the actual width of the hallway?
The width is 40 feet.
Width?
Width, 40 feet?
40 feet wide, and about 100, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20,
okay.
Each one's 20. So it's about a 400 foot long hallway.
And how high?
And you're about 40 feet on it. The ceiling's 100 feet high.
Right.
I go to the first doors on the left of the hallway. And go check it out. Anything interesting?
Not locked. Wooden door.
Uh-huh.
Open the door. It's a bedroom. Like a but very very sterile, very clean. You know, large giant sized bed, bureau, a little desk.
Okay. Let's.
We're just looking around at this point.
The bed's turned down. There's a little chocolate on it.
No, it doesn't look like that. There's no sheets or anything like that. It's just the mat. You know, it's like a frame.
If there were sheets, they'd be probably have been.
Yeah, so I go. I go to the door to the right now, and I basically keep opening doors as we walk down the hallway.
So you guys are just going to continue walking down the hallway,
checking it out. Yeah.
Okay.
You set off this.
Yep.
This is Brian's fault. He's not here.
I mean, I have a high perception. I just don't get a chance to use it.
No, the it is a magical trap.
I have, like, a plus 13 for knowledge arcana.
So, like this? Like pen? You guys are going to love this one.
Uh-huh.
You get points for setting off the trap?
Oh, yeah. You found it.
You found
it.
I found the trap.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
I could also use Arcane Eye and probably map out this whole place. 8. But, yeah, this is more fun.
Okay. Oops, I went in.
Yeah.
Stone giant, first door, stairs, stairs, second door, third door, like that?
Yeah.
Hallway goes a long way. So you guys are at second door?
Mm-hmm.
Everybody happy where they are?
Yep.
And these are all medium-sized doors?
No, these are large doors, giant-sized doors, right?
So huge-sized doors.
Yeah. Okay, on the far north wall, you see a giant stone ball emerge, fall out of the wall, and start rolling towards you.
It's a giant stone ball.
Correct.
Is it the length of? Is it the width of the hallway?
It is the width of the hallway. But it doesn't go to the roof. It's a round ball, right? So there's room above it.
Technically, also we can shove into the corners.
Yeah, that's my thought is that it's a big 40 foot wide. There's got to be
lay low.
For harsh die.
Harsh
die's going
to
be stuck.
Harsh die needs to go to the door.
Can we just go into the room?
Yep.
Go into the room.
Okay, everyone jumps into the same room. He goes in this one. You guys go in this one. Is that fair?
Yeah.
Okay. You hear this ball? I mean, it's moving like 200 feet. By the time it gets here, it's going like 200 feet per initiative instance, right?
Okay.
So it's going extremely fast. It slams down into the end of the wall where you would expect it to explode, break, crash, but you don't hear any kind of crashing or smashing.
Okay.
It was smashed the statue. If it didn't smash the statue.
No, statue was over here.
Yeah. If I don't hear this crashing.
That's the end of round one. Ball slams into the wall. You don't hear the slamming. You guys are in the doors.
Right.
Go poke my head back out and take a look.
Okay, there is a... The statue has caught the ball and is walking down the hallway rolling it.
Okay.
So the ball is about, 40 feet back up the hallway at this point. He's rolling it.
He's rolling it.
Correct.
And does he look like a giant or like a stone?
It looks like a giant, but it doesn't look like alive.
Okay.
Like golem-y? Stone golem-y, maybe?
Okay. Yeah, probably stone golem. Slippy
man out there.
Golem. Is he,
I said golem earlier.
Is he paying attention to us? Does he see us?
It doesn't seem like he's just rolling the ball back up the hallway.
Okay. I just let him roll by.
Okay. He rolls it all the way back. You guys watch him. He doesn't notice you. He kind of slides it up the wall, and it goes back in the wall, and then he starts walking back down the hallway. Gets down the hallway and retakes his position here.
Go to the next.
Oh, well, he's busy. We're gonna go look at the other place. Oh, he's busy rolling up.
Okay, so you guys exit the door, and go to the next room.
While he's busy rolling up the wall.
Wait! Can someone do a detect magic or something and find the tripwires on the floor or just something?
We have rooms we can go into. It's going to take me like 10 minutes to go to this. We can just simply search the whole place. All right. Before I get stuck.
Run up to the next door. You go in. Same exact thing. Nothing unusual in that room at all whatsoever. That's the third one on the left-hand side. You go to the fourth one. There is a fissure in the wall. So it looks like maybe an earthquake or something occurred and cracked the wall on the back wall that leads into what appears to be a cavern or cave system.
All right. Make a mental note of that. Next room.
Next room. You're now at the... fifth one, open the door, same thing. Simple room, bed. Yeah. Next one, you guys trip the trap again. The ball starts rolling, you guys jump in the rooms, Everybody's cool. Search the room and same
thing. I thought it'd take time for the actual golem to walk. So the golem just simply catches it midway.
Well, you guys watched him go the whole time.
We're not going to watch the whole time.
I thought you watched the whole time.
No, we're not going to fucking watch it. We're going to use the time to actually look at the rooms.
If we don't watch the entire time, he's going to attack us. What do you want that?
We're just trying to simply banish him then.
Oh.
We simply just say
fine, done. Let's attack
the seventh last no, room well, is much wanted. Nicer. Like a guest suite. There's actually sheets on the bed. There's a large cupboard or an armoire, if you will, or some kind of cabinet in the corner. The desk is much nicer. There's writing utensils on the desk.
So we found the armoire of invincibility.
Incorrect.
Ah.
Is there any good in there?
There is a large steel great axe leaning against the armoire.
Could that be the missing weapon?
Yeah.
No, it'd be it.
Let's.
I don't remember three weapons being so. How does it? What is it? Does it look like it's well made? Well,
it does. Does it looks incredible? Harshnag is very impressed by it. He's like, wow, that is quite a looking axe. Not as good as mine, ha ha ha! But great, nevertheless.
I don't remember Thrum having such wit. Usually having good looking axes.
It's a nice axe.
But usually most of the it's not. I mean, that would be more the bollock of Sir Tur.
Right. No. This is beautiful.
So I say it's our hidden weapon. Let's pick it up and keep going.
So let's ask Harshnag if. Hey, what do you think about taking this and putting it into the hands of the giant?
Wonderful idea.
Okay, so we asked Harshnag, because we can't lift this. Could you lift this and carry it?
Yeah.
Us?
He throws it over his shoulder. Now he's got two great axes.
Okay, great. So we go back to the main room.
Is there anything else in there more?
You open the cat. Nothing else in there, obviously. Search? Give me a roll.
Oh, if you want me to search, then I can search.
Yeah. I rolled a natural 20.
There you go. There is a hidden compartment. You open the hidden compartment. There is two books, ledgers, hidden in the bottom of the armoire.
Okay, give them to him.
Right, written in giant financial accounting papers.
Giant-sized books, but Zephyr's the size. Like,
oh, right, they are large, and it looks like mostly financial accounting, church document kinds of stuff. Rituals, very old, 350 years old.
Right.
Okay.
You find anything about the special door?
It'll take me time to actually read the entire thing.
Well, we got time.
Flipping the pages is rather laborious.
Yeah. The thing is huge. You're all having to work together.
I do not want to rip it. It looks like it's quite old.
No table of contents.
What do I say?
It's a counting ledger, right? Okay. So it's mostly just financial data.
Okay, so let's head back up to the main room. We'll have Harshnag
put this back. We'll put it back in for the time. Harshnag, we'll bring it out, I guess.
No, put it back. You're not going to look at it. We never asked him where it's odd that it was hidden, though.
Well, I mean, you usually want to put these kind of things.
And we explored all the doors in the hallway?
No.
You've just gone down the left-hand side?
Okay, so now we're going to hit the right-hand side
you
on the way back.
You trip the trap at some point, hide, keep going. You go through the rooms, all look like hotel rooms. The one at the end is nicer than the other ones. It also has an armoire and all that kind of stuff, but it doesn't look anything different.
Okay.
Hidden stuff in the same place?
No, hidden stuff in the same place. There's no hidden compartment in that armoire. You check.
Okay. So let's.
There's a fissure in one of the walls.
I do not believe that's part of the shrine itself.
Okay. Well, we could.
But since Curiosity killed the cat, let's go through there anyway.
Is it giant-sized fissure in there? Is it like how big is that?
It's large. I mean, it goes almost up to the ceiling, and it's
a giant.
And probably a giant would squeeze in if he had to. Like Harshtag could probably get in there if he had to, but it is narrow.
Yeah, I think we're getting Harshtag. I think we're getting sidetracked going into it, going to a fissure like this.
Well, do you think that, or do you know that?
I think it.
Well, let's go and let's put the axe back or in that giant's hands, and then let's see what happens. and then
put him in the sconces and see if it opens the gateway.
Yeah, I mean, we've got plenty of doors to go check out. All else fails, we can go back to this crevasse or this,
crevasse,
whatever it is. It's the
crevice.
Yeah, the crevasse. I'm trying to pronounce things.
It's a fissure.
A fishaz.
Alright, so you go back, ignoring the fissure, go back to the main temple. Harshnag has this giant axe.
Okay, so he puts it in, have him put it in the hands of the giant that was missing a weapon.
Yep, he puts it back in the giant's hand, nothing happens.
Okay.
It fits in perfectly, though.
Ask him if he can put the weapons in the sconces that match the type of giant.
Put it in the Issei, rune.
Okay, so he takes it and slides it into the rune. When he does so, thunder erupts from the archway. Mists begin swirling and all sorts of stuff. It looks absolutely crazy.
Okay, so let's have him take the weapons out of the other giant's hands and have him slide those weapons into the sconces.
Did it open the portal?
Does it look like
the portal's open, right?
It looks like the portal's open, but it doesn't look... I mean, it looks very cloudy and stormy and chaotic inside the portal. It's not like a nice, clean walking portal, but you could jump through the storm if you wanted to. It definitely looks like the portal has been opened.
Okay, well, I'm going to speak to the party. It looks like either each one of these weapons might open a portal to, like, the different home of that kind of giant or something. Or maybe you put all of them in and it opens a super clean portal that takes us...
I don't believe if this is the use of the transit, it would be a lot more used, I would think.
Well, that's true. Probably.
Churning thunderclouds lit by flashing but harmless lightning. Dimly through there, it appears that you can see another chamber.
So I'm going to put my trestle back in my extra dimensional space.
Yes.
And then go through there.
All right, so you walk through.
For science. Yes.
Yeah. He jumps through the portal, and you see him, you know, he seems to kind of transmute, teleport through the thing.
I quickly pull the axe out.
You don't have the strength for that.
Arsnack, we're going to play a joke on our party member.
Okay. So
someone wants a baseball fireball.
Do we see him over there?
Yeah, it looks like he's now standing in a chamber on the other side of the archway.
Okay, I guess I follow him.
All right, you jump through. Everybody jumps through. Beyond the thundering archway lies a hexagonal chamber whose walls rise 50 feet before tapering to a 90-foot high apex. Standing in each corner of the room is a life-size statue of a giant holding a heavy iron lantern with one arm raised. Each type of giant is again represented here. Hill, stone, frost, fire, cloud, storm. A cold magical light radiates from each lantern, illuminating a giant corpse lying on the floor beneath a shroud of frost in the middle of the room. The corpse looks like it has been here for some time, preserved by the cold. Next to the body rests a giant frost-covered morning star.
Oh, well, and obviously the head is caved in.
The head is caved in.
Oh, poor Sod.
Any doors?
So what kind of, no doors, what, no what windows.
Kind of, and what sort of giant is this?
The
obviously is it fat? Is it muscular? Is it a little bit stouter? They're looking.
These are
fairly indicative.
Fire giant.
No, he has little fangs on him, or he has tusks.
A vampire giant.
Tusks, not fangs.
An orc giant?
No.
Cloud giant.
Yeah. Oh. The cloud giants have a little tusk fangs.
So he is a cloud giant. He is dead.
And he's here. His weapon is here. And it's big.
The archway behind you looks very similar to what it did when you came through, except for there are no runes or sconces in it.
Hmm. Because I walk around. Is there anything...
Obviously, I'm looking at the clothes. I'm looking at... Because I haven't really haven't got a chance to look at any Sky Jotun before.
Yes. He does appear to have a very nice breastplate on. Golden breastplate.
I ask Harshnag, is that a breastplate that you could use?
Oh, it looks magical. Shall I remove it from the corpse?
Is that?
Yeah, let's remove it from the corpse.
See, I want to before we
start this.
I want to actually get a
no.
Okay.
No.
Is there anything else of interest? Like, I'm looking, trying to actually get a good idea of like what his clothing is like. Trying to get a good. You mad? Especially while, flip him over.
nothing. Right. Nothing.
He's like face first down.
Yeah. As you flip him over, a blue ethereal ghost emerges from him.
Oh, I turn the ghost.
What brings you here? How dare you interrupt my sleep?
Can I turn undead?
We are, there's been a...
You are small folk. You have no business being in the Temple of the All-Father.
For some reason, the All-Father has broken the ordaining, and we are now on a mission to try to restore it before... the giants, destroy our lands.
Do you speak the truth?
The ordering has definitely been shattered.
And the king? Has he not restored it?
We're looking for the king.
We can't find the king.
Well, I'm destroyed the ordering. It's not something that even the king of Stormjaw.
Oh, I would never destroy the ordering. He loves his children. Unlike my evil father who betrayed me here.
And who is your father?
Blagothakis.
No, it's
Blogthakis.
Blakothakis.
Blakothakis. My father.
I love making the DM pronounce hard names.
So
Blog, my dad. Betrayed me within this temple when we came here to inquire.
We understand that the ordning was destroyed due to displeasure on how the giants handled a recent uprising by dragons.
Horrible. It needs to be restored immediately.
We're working on that.
We are here for answers, of course.
Oh, the ghost kind of gestures to the floor, and you see that there are giant runes etched in a huge circle, kind of that goes underneath each one of them. There's snow over the runes, so it's difficult to read them.
Go on. Shit. Get the snow off.
He points to them, so yeah, the ghost isn't doing anything.
Go on, get the snow off.
So I'm sweeping the snow off of the runes.
And you're able to read the runes. It looks like it says, ask your question and know the truth. It's actually written in Deathic, which is a dwarven script.
Giant is also written in Deathic.
Yeah, but it's written in a very elaborate, very flowy, very ornate kind of fashion.
Well, that's definitely dwarven.
No, it's definitely giant. This probably predates dwarves even.
Yeah, it looks very old.
Okay, so
dwarves do not want to admit it, but most of their language is actually built off of giant runes.
Sad but true.
Yes, I mock the dwarves simultaneously.
So
ask your question, know your answer. So and the ghost is like, and you should not be using that power. Only giants. I'm surprised this man has come with you.
Harshnag has shown us this way. Shown us to this.
And Harshnag is unhappy with this ghost. He looks very uncomfortable with this ghost being here.
Something wrong, Harshnag?
Undead is not healthy and should not be here.
Blame Blakothakis. Blame Blakothakis then. For each slot he killed. Who are you to him? For his father.
Son.
He killed his own son here.
Where is your father?
After he slayed me, he must have left. Trapping me, haunting me here forever.
Is there something we can do to release your spirit?
Yes. You need to slay my father.
Oh. Okay.
Do I know anything about this Blakothakis?
Give me a roll.
What do I need to roll?
Like this would be kind of wisdom-y check.
Wisdom-y?
Wisdom-y.
History?
History, yeah, history's good.
Not Int History?
History, Int History.
All right, cool. 31.
Yeah. You have actually heard of this legendary cloud giant, Blog.
Blokothus.
But you don't know, I mean, he's legendary from a long time ago. That's all you really know at this point. You don't know that.
But if a if there's not even any mention of him anywhere,
yeah.
I probably heard of him.
Yeah, so you do know that he's tied to some legendary city named Parsnast. Parsnast? How is that pronunciation?
It's Parnast.
Parnast.
It's not a legendary city. It's a town in the middle of fucking Poduck nowhere in the middle of Savage Frontier. We know that because we've been running adventures there. I have been to the Great Peaks, the Iron Baron.
You know that there is some kind of relationship between him and that, but you're not sure what it is.
Parn. So,
do you have any ideas where we could find your father?
Perhaps his castle was built there or crashed there at some point. You're not exactly sure.
I remember some mentions of him being near Parn.
Cloud giants flying cloud castles.
V5 that kind of thing.
Are the walls made of cloud?
Are these D&D type UFOs or something?
Yes.
No, it's like Jack the Giant Killer, V5 Fell Thumb stuff.
They're actually UFGs, unidentified flying giants.
You guys have actually been in one of these already.
Well, even in a small tower, not a full size.
So he doesn't have any idea where we can find his father.
No.
I remember him being. Remember.
Do you have anything you could?
But if you slayed him, I would be freed.
Okay. Is there anything you can do to help us on our journey?
I'm currently a ghost. I'm trapped here.
What about your reformation?
If I were to be freed, I would repay you lavishly.
Hmm. Do you know why your father killed you?
He was overcome with despair and envy when he learned the truth from the Oracle. The truth that I one day would rise to prominence.
Doesn't sound like the Oracle's very accurate.
Things are not going very well right now. But I think with your help, I will one day restore honor to my people and help you restore the ordering. I am so shocked and surprised that it has been destroyed.
How many questions may we ask the Oracle?
We were able to ask 3 before my father rose up and destroyed me. You could try to do an Arcana check on the runes.
Sure, give me. Okay, then. Cool, you know what I have expertise in. 31!
You're guessing probably 6 questions before it would run out of energy. Mm. You also recognize that being in this room is risky. The door that you opened is probably going to close fairly soon.
Mm.
So there is some urgency to get out of here.
All right, then. So then, I'm going to ask some questions, then.
6 questions, team. That's 1 each.
Where's the Oracle located, maybe?
Well, the Oracle is here.
Well, this is the Oracle.
The Oracle is kind of this glowing orb in the roof, you think.
All right, then. So then, I'll get the definitive. I want the definitive answer first.
What is the meaning of life?
Or I slapped him in silence. I asked the first and most definitive one because it is to be. Because we're not 100% sure, but this is probably most of them. Is that? So then I asked the Oracle, why has the ordering been shattered?
The ordering was shattered because the giants disappointed the Allfather.
Where?
One.
Everybody good? That doesn't surprise anybody. You're not sure you should ask any more questions.
Well, it's the definitive one.
Correct.
So now, how do we restore the ordering now with that?
Well, obviously, Obnom has to put it back to you.
Maybe there's another option.
Obviously, everyone's trying to actually impress on. But I ask you, what is your name?
That's the second question.
The Oracle.
No, not the Oracle, the son's name.
The ghost?
Yes.
The ghost's name is Igernon.
Igernon.
That was pretty close. Igernon.
So, Igernon, what is the star? We've heard of a Storm King. What is his name?
You guys have actually heard this as well. It's King Hecaton.
Where is King Hecaton?
You ask this?
Yes.
The oracle actually makes some kind of, like, arcane grinding noise?
It's like 404
And he's like, King Hecaton is beyond my reach, it says in a kind of strange voice.
Time to leave.
Where does...
Unknown starts echoing. Like, it's a weird...
404 not
it's,
found.
It's behaving in a different way than you thought. Like, this is not a good question.
we're just like a 404.
The storm starts rallying within the archway, but it doesn't answer the question. It basically says, unknown, I can't find him.
How about what needs to be done?
I ask also, Hecaton also, one other thing. Where does Hecaton live? Actually, not the Oracle.
Hecaton's court is beneath the sea.
Is there a name for that court?
Well, one of those things had a trident. That's probably a good place to start.
Is there a name for the court?
Yes,
there is.
But does he know?
Yeah, he does know the name of Hecaton's court.
Okay, so then I will ask then, because I already know the name.
I think that the trident will open a gateway to it.
It's a good idea.
So... I asked the Oracle then, how may we reach Maelstrom?
Maelstrom is the name of his court. To reach Maelstrom, you need... It's just, you need to find a conch. Find a magic conch of the Storm Giant King. Use it to visit Hecaton's court. Reach out to the evil so you need to... There is a conch shell that you need to discover. And the conch will take you to Maelstrom. King Hecaton's conch will take you there. The path you choose here will lead you to it.
Where may we find the conch?
So that's 3 is the conch. 4 is where is the conch?
Where may we find a conch for that purpose?
Can you say it's here?
If he is, that would be a make it easy.
First, you must prove yourself. When human barbarians came to these lands, they fought our kind and stole our relics, burying them in the ground. The humans built altars to Uthgar, their god king, atop these relics and surrounded their altars with burial mounds. Go to these mounds, retrieve one or more of our lost relics, and bring them here as tribute. Do this and your path will be made clear. There are many paths you can take. The more relics you deliver, the more paths you will have to choose from. Several evil giant lords stand ready to oppose you. You can ruin all of their plans by defeating just one of them. Which one remains to be seen? He says.
Wow.
Sounded like
those questions.
That's where is the conch? That was the answer, which is
where
go get relics, bring them back here. You will get a path to the conch.
Okay. And do we know where the relics are?
Well, that's we need to
Uthgard burial mounds is what he said.
Yeah,
Uthgard burial mounds. Okay.
These are cool.
Question?
I'll let the peanut gallery ask the last one.
No, 2. You've asked 4.
Oh, 2 more. Okay, so
there's 2
what,
more.
What would convince the All Father to restore the Ordinate?
His children rising from their complacency.
Let me rephrase that before you answer.
Well, that was a good answer.
That's a good answer. Okay. Well, my how I rephrase this, what can we do, humans, to convince the All-Father to restore the order?
Find a magic conch, visit King Hecaton, root the evil from his court.
Okay.
What evil is there in his court?
Everyone good with that being the final question?
Sure.
What evil is in his court? Hold on just a sec. He was misled by his evil, his eldest daughters, Mirin and Nim. They covet his throne.
Oh.
And that's it.
That's it. It goes dark. The clouds begin to rally in the portal area.
Let's get back through that portal before it goes away.
Okay.
What about that mace, though?
Oh, the Morning Star.
Morning Star that's laying on the ground.
It's a giant Morning Star.
It's large.
It is huge.
It is huge.
Okay, so we leave.
You exit. You're back in the main kind of area.
There's a set of double doors to the south of us?
There are double doors to the south of you as well.
Okay.
I would like to actually look through the rest of the shrine just for historical purposes.
You head to the south doors. Let me make sure that they open. Again, they're coated with ice, and these ones are actually very difficult to open.
Can we just get a credit? We don't need to open it all the way.
Could we, like, use your credit card to...
where is... How hard is it? Hold on.
Wait.
No, it's not work. Best.
Yeah, so it looks like the ice is actually blocking your ability to open.
You don't get to correct both rooms. You only get to correct one room at a time.
They're covered in 4 inches of thick ice. Looks like you'd have to chip away the ice before you could enter, or maybe melt the ice with something very hot. Like a fireball spell, perhaps.
Yeah, back up.
Back up.
Yeah, fireball.
Boom. Ice is melted off the doors, and once the doors are melted, it is very easy to open them.
They're stone doors. That should be able to
happen. Yeah, the doors take the damage, no problem. The ice melts, standing in a pool of water, which reminds you of the bloody pool from the entryway. You are able to pull them open. You see a room 240 feet wide by 440 feet deep, with 200-foot-wide alcove in the center of the east wall. 6 pillars, each 20 feet in diameter and 60 feet tall, support a vaulted ceiling. The walls are lined with with niches. Nikes and scones identical to the ones in areas 3 and 6. There is
more damage.
A hungry... Oh, God. Remorhaz curled up in the alcove.
A hungry Remorhaz?
Yes.
What's that look like?
I will show you. So you open the doors. It begins to uncurl from the pillar that it's wrapped around. It is giant.
It is huge, I think.
Yeah. You're going to like this. Ooh. It looks like that.
So we are so killing that.
Oh, gee.
So basically, what
so but basically, you've entered a giant feasting hall, and there's this giant, I don't know how to describe it, snow worm from hell.
Okay. Initiative.
And then I don't know if I'm going to have time for like this.
Yep. Let me get, it's going to be this.
Yeah. Yeah, I didn't read this beforehand. I prepared for last.
It's here, you guys are at door there. So they've decided to attack it. Varus,
huh?
So we are rolling initiative.
Oh, aggressive?
What is it?
It's aggressive, yeah.
It is uncurling and looks aggressive.
It is not a kitty.
It is not a kitty, it is pissed off.
Oh, man. I have fought smaller ones, I have fought young ones of these.
Yeah, no, this is not a young one. This one is freaking huge. As it's uncurling, the spikes on its back begin to light up.
Yep. They have a hot body to them.
Mark, Fred.
14.
14. That might be your high roll yet. Sam?
Let's see.
Yes.
10.
Scott.
11.
And Jeff?
20.
Jeff, you are first. Go ahead.
I wouldn't try hitting with your sword.
Not with my sword?
I wouldn't try getting close to hit it. It'll hurt. It'll be fairly painful for you.
Okay, so I pull out my bow.
Okay.
And I take a shot at it with my bow.
Twing!
I got a 20.
20 is a hit?
First thing, reach can probably get away. Canada.
And let me see. Ranged is a D...
Where is the Remorhaz? Or is that
six points of damage?
These dice.
Okay.
Six points
of damage with an arrow.
I'm gonna do it and get another one. That's a miss.
Okay. Next up, Fred, you're up.
Sacred flame.
What else do I see in this room?
So the room is a giant feast hall. So there are these six giant pillars. It's unwrapping around one and charging at you guys. The rest is giant tables. There's a huge alcove that looks like it may have been used to serve food from and that kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing else readily apparent. fire pit in the center. Giant fire pit. The vaulted ceilings are relatively high.
But nothing sticks. Nothing pops out like, oh, loot.
No, there's no clearly identifiable loot.
Okay, did he save saving throw?
The Remorhaz is saving. He got a 12 plus 1 is 13. He does not.
By Lathander! I got a 4.
Okay, takes 4.
We have 11 minutes.
Roll fast.
All right, you're up.
Right. I'll make this good and short because we're just gonna basically go bye-bye. Go bypass. And that's we don't want to fight you right now. Banish.
You're vanishing on the whole party.
No, I'm banishing it.
You're gonna banish it?
Yep. Give me a DC 17 check. Charisma check.
Charisma?
Charisma save.
9.
He poofs.
Can he come back?
He gets he has time out for a minute.
How many?